So let's have to get ourselves some cameras and a gift voucher really, and decided to spend it on getting some CCTV cameras. And these are the site that I decided to go for. They're made by Swan, and they're pretty good cameras. They're aluminium cased, outdoor waterproof, and they're what they call multi-purpose. But they're colour, monochrome for night, they've got infrared, and they've also got a thing which, according to the book, they got an IR cut filter. The idea of that is during the daytime it cuts the amount of IR coming into the lens, so you don't get blowout apparently. So that's the manual that comes with it. It's basically it's front cover, couple of pages, and that's it. And there's another language, but it's easy to set up. The bracket is sort of positionable in just about any sort of direction. Takes a bit of getting used to, like if you want to go sort of down and to the left or something like that at the same time, but you soon work it out. They seem to have some support numbers there for UK as well, so so obviously a pretty good make if you've got support phone numbers and email available. And yeah, I like them. They're as I say, they're robust. Unlike some cameras, the cable actually goes through the bracket rather than coming outside, so the cable itself is protected from getting damaged. So that's it. And then I thought, well, now I need to be able to record it, so I looked around for a DVR, and Swan do make DVRs. The one I actually went for was a K-Moon. It's a nice little unit. I actually thought this was bigger than this, but it's, you know, it's quite a nice sort of size unit. It will sit on the shelf quite nicely. Two lights on the front, one with power, and the other one with record. This one's a red one, that's a blue one, with the infrared sensor on there. Comes with a remote control. But most of the time I control it with a mouse. It does come with a mouse, but where I've got this on the shelf, the cable on the mouse is a bit on the short side. Luckily I've had a spare mouse with a decent sized cable on it, and plug that in and it works just fine with that. Just a standard Logitech mouse. And on the back, plenty of connections. This one's actually an 8 channel. I decided to go to 8 channel because I know I'm going to fill up 4 channels more or less straight away, and it pays to have the extra ports on there for the extra cost. This one's also got 4 channels of audio. You can plug mics into there, but you need to get the special amplified microphones for these. I tried with a standard capsule mic and it doesn't work, even though you power the capsule. It's not enough signal there, but you can get proper amplified microphones for these, and they're fine. Audio out. Also, you've got video out, VGA, HDMI, and Ethernet, and you can obviously view it online from anywhere you like. 2 USB ports, one will be for the mouse, and the other one you can plug in a external drive or flash drive to save any clips to it if you want to put it through for evidence to the police and things like that. This connector here is a little plug-in connector. This is for the PTZ control if you've got cameras that got PTZ, and then you've got your power connector. Runs on 12 volts. Same with the cameras, they all come with power supplies. If you get a pack of two, it comes with one power supply for the two, and it gives you a splitter cable. And then take a quick look inside. And that's the bulk of it. There's your controller board, processor and that, all your connections on the back, backup battery for your processor, I guess. It doesn't come with a hard drive. This is just one I had lying about. It's only about 150 gigabyte. I'm going to get another one at some point. It's more like terabyte, especially when I start getting a few more cameras to add to the system. So when you look at the cost of this, remember to add in the cost of a hard drive. So that's the sort of overview. I'll put this back online and show you it operational. So this is the night vision in infrared mode. As you can see, I've got three images up there. The top two are the spawn cameras. The bottom one is an old security camera that I've got down the back garden at the moment, or pointing out the window, so not a very good picture on that. But basically you double click on one of the images and that brings up one of the cameras on full screen, and as you see, it's quite a clear image of there. And that's done one side of the house, and mountains in the background is just coming up to dawn. You just see the light coming over the top there. Street lights, the one on the left is an LED light, and the ones on the right are still the old sodium, so that gives you an idea of the lighting. And that's just the back garden. So this is in day mode, as you can see, and basically we've got the mouse. Don't worry about that one, that's the computer mouse. This is the one for the CCTV. As you can see, I've got the arrow over the black square, and this is the remote control. So all I was doing earlier was just moving the mouse over to one of the images to select it. You can change the modes, so if you just want to view one camera, rather pointless on this one, but it gives you the list of the cameras. You can go to four cameras, but and you can choose 1 to 4 or 5 to 8. You can choose the 8 camera mode, which gives you one image in the middle, and then you double click on the image that you want to bring up. You see, it's this is early morning. It's as I say, it's dawn, and the sun is soon be coming over the top of the mountains there. The other one, although this is 8 channels, if you go on to view 9, you get the tic-tac-toe pattern, and in the 9th square, you actually get the readout of what the cameras are passing through. And these are around about 900 kilobytes per second, just touching on 1,000 there. The ones that are not set to record, they're around about the 20 to 30, so that's something that's useful there. And go back to the view 4, check select 1 to 4. Right click to get all these menus. Main menu is password protected. Okay, as you saw, it was a on-screen keyboard. Not too bad to use. You don't want to put long and complicated passwords in there, but you obviously want to put something that's secure. The record tab, you got the record control, you got the playback, and you got the backup. There's alarms, so you can do motion detect, video loss, video blind, and abnormality. So you got some different things. Motion detect, I haven't actually tried this yet, but it eventually brings up a grid, I believe, if there's anything like the other ones. System, you can go into general settings, does your time and date, things like that. Encoding, network, so you can set up your network. Net services, not sure exactly what that is. Display, so you can set up what the what appears on your display and the transparency of this window. Resolution and channel, so you can do this for each channel. PTZ configuration, I haven't got that. RS232, there's a tour on there, again I haven't watched that, and digital. Advanced storage, so you can check what storage you've got. Upgrades, device info, auto maintain, restore to factory settings, import and export, and you log out. The backup, you select your camera, etc. Go into backup. As you have not selected a device, well, I haven't got a device plugged in, so I can't plug that one at the moment. So yeah, you got quite a lot of information there. Right click to get rid of it. So it's fairly intuitive, but if you're familiar with CCTV, then it shouldn't be too hard to find. So there you go. That's So over to the remote control. Very basic. It's just select which camera you want to view. You've got modes up here. Obviously you can't get it on the screen while I'm doing it. You can flip between 4, 8, 9 and back to 1. So you can do that with the remote control. There's a few other things on there. If you're in the wrong position, you've got an escape button. You've got the menu with your cursors, and then you've got your play and all that lot when you're searching for the scene that you want to save. But to be honest, I think most of it you can do. If you go into playback, you can select a date, and this has got 5 days saved. I'm only recording 3 cameras at the moment. There's like 5 days saved there, so I can go into Friday, for instance, select a time, and select the, that's got 1 and 2 selected. If I just wanted number 2, okay, I've probably got to stop that, yeah, that's what it is. Yeah, so if I stop it first, I can select just number 2 when you click on the cursor. As you can see, the that was Friday, and the sun came up, and it went behind the mountain. So you stop playing and then up window, and that takes you back to that's a live view, and that's the sun coming up. So I think it's time to close this video out, and those are the items I bought.